What's up everyone? Hafiz here from Hafiz channel, and today we have the Desire S. We're gonna do the unboxing of the Desire S. The Desire S is the so-called award-winning phone that is actually the Desire, but a better version of it. And we're gonna do the unboxing right here, right now. So just a little bit background on this phone. It's running Gingerbread, Android 2.3. It's a HTC device, it's a unibody, and it's quite interesting. This phone is sort of the smaller brother to the incredible S. So let's take a look, shall we? Right. Let's see if we can open this up. And there we have it. Alright, so I'm gonna pull this tab out, and here's the Desire S. It is quite nice, and as you can see, this is the aluminum plate. Very nice construction. Right, so let's give a little tour on this. We have the rocker buttons over here. We have the USB port, and this is the battery. Let's see if we can pull it out. Yep, there's the battery inside, and the camera. The camera is a 5 megapixel camera, supports 720p video recording. The front facing camera is a VGA. Not too shabby for this kind of phone. And we have the search button, the back menu, and the home button over here. So let's see what else we get in the box. I'm gonna set this Desire S aside for a while. Open this up, and yeah, the normal HTC quick guide, safety and regulator guide, warranty statement, and contact us. This kind of stuff doesn't really bother you much if you really know what you're doing. So, you get this nice plastic over here, and I'm guessing that this is the UK 3-pin plug, and we have the adapter right here. Also, very nice. I think this is a degradable plastic or something, so I'm not sure about this, but yes, so you put it in here and then you're good to go to charge your phone. Over here we have the HTC ear jack. If you can see it clear, I mean, the earpiece, it's okay. And we have the micro USB. You can see that it's quite long. But anyway, so we'll go back to the phone. We're gonna set this aside. Nothing else in the box, just this and some specs on the side here, and focus more on the phone. The phone is a battery, lithium ion battery. It has a capacity of 1450 milliampere power, which gives you about approximate talk time of 435 minutes on WCDMA and 590 minutes for GSM. Standby time is about 455 hours. We also have an internal phone storage of 1.1 gigabytes and a RAM of 768 megabytes. So, plenty of space in this phone. It's Android running with HTC Sense. It has a Snapdragon processor, which is something like the Desire. We have the Desire right here. You can say the grandfather of the Desire S, and this is also running a 1 GHz Snapdragon processor, but is of older technology. So we're gonna look at some size comparison here, and if you can roughly gauge, it's almost the same, but it seems as though that the Desire S is slightly thicker, but it is, in fact, I'm talking about the height wise, it is shorter than the Desire, but no trackball. Over here, we can't see, we don't have any trackball, and this is the normal buttons that you press. This is a capacitive button, so I'm gonna put that aside. And we're gonna compare it to the iPad 2 that I have right here, and we're gonna see when compared to Desire S how thin it really is. And yeah, it's about the same for me. I think the iPad 2 is still thinner, but those are two different types. So that's the tablet. We're gonna see whether we can boot this phone up. It's so called that it has that 3 second boot up time. Let's see if it starts up first. Can we do it? Let's see, I'm not too sure. And we hear the sound, but yeah, there we go. All boot up and ready to go. Very nice. So it is running the latest version of HTC Sense. You have the all app tray, the favorites, this is the frequent, and your download. Other than that, what's new onto this HTC Sense feature is that you have a quick setting where you have your Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi hotspot, GPS, mobile network, and all of your settings. So it's very fast to go around. And yep, so this is the unboxing of the Desire S. It's quite a light phone when you compare it to the actual Desire. I think maybe Desire S is slightly lighter than the Desire, because it feels as though the Desire S is lighter by not so much, but it is, in fact, it's a light phone. I would recommend this phone if you guys were wondering if you can get it priced about Singapore dollars at about $580. So I would totally recommend this phone. So that is the unboxing of the HTC Desire S. Thank you very much for watching.